Hello and welcome to Amazing Aircraft. What do you get when you combine a pencil-thin wing, a powerful engine, and a legendary engineer? You get the Lockheed F-104 Starfighter, one of the most controversial and influential jet fighters of the Cold War era. Designed by Kelly Johnson, the genius behind the Skunk Works, the F-104 Starfighter was envisioned as a simple, lightweight, and high-performance aircraft that could outfly any enemy fighter. It was the first U.S. jet fighter to fly at twice the speed of sound, setting numerous world records for speed, altitude, and climb rate. However, it was also involved in several conflicts and controversies, such as the Taiwan Strait crisis, the Vietnam War, the Indo-Pakistani wars, and the Lockheed bribery scandals. In this video, we will explore the history and achievements of the F-104 Starfighter and see why it was both admired and criticized by pilots, engineers, and politicians. So, are you ready to dive into its story? Then buckle up and let's go! The F-104 project began in 1951 when Kelly Johnson, the lead designer at Lockheed Skunk Works, visited USAF air bases in South Korea to talk to fighter pilots who were facing the MiG-15 in combat. The pilots wanted a simple, lightweight, and high-performance aircraft that could outfly any enemy fighter. Johnson and his team decided to design a radical wing that was very thin, straight, and mid-mounted, reducing drag and increasing speed at high altitudes. They also chose the new General Electric J79 turbojet engine, which was much more powerful and reliable than previous engines. Additionally, they equipped the F-104 with advanced avionics, such as a fire control system, a radar, and an ejection seat. The F-104 had a unique and distinctive appearance, with a long and slender fuselage, a T-tail, and a sharply pointed nose. The wings were only 2.13 meters long and 3.4% thick, with no flaps or ailerons. Instead, the F-104 used a system of boundary layer control, blowing high-pressure air over the trailing edge of the wing to increase lift and control. The engine was a single J79, capable of producing up to 70.4 kilonewtons of thrust with an afterburner, giving the F-104 a thrust-to-weight ratio of more than 1:1. The armament consisted of a 20mm M61 Vulcan cannon, and 7 hardpoints for missiles, bombs, or rockets. The radar was a NASARRR-21, which could detect and track targets at long ranges. The ejection seat was a downward-firing C-2, allowing the pilot to escape at low altitudes and speeds. The F-104 first flew on February 17, 1956, and entered service with the USAF in March 1958. However, the F-104 faced several problems during testing and production. Issues included high landing speed, engine reliability, and limited radar capability. To solve these problems, the F-104 underwent several improvements, such as adding a boundary layer splitter plate, a variable inlet cone, and a larger nose cone. More powerful versions of the J-79 engine increased the top speed to Mach 2.2. The F-104 was versatile and served in various roles for the U.S. Air Force and other air forces worldwide. However, it faced criticisms for its poor maneuverability, short range, and high accident rate. The F-104 first saw combat in 1958 during the Second Taiwan Strait Crisis, when the U.S. Air Force deployed 12 F-104As and 2 F-104Bs to Taiwan to deter Chinese MiG-15 and MiG-17 fighters. The Starfighters performed supersonic runs over the strait, but did not engage in air-to-air combat. The presence of the F-104s helped prevent a full-scale war between China and Taiwan. During the Berlin Crisis of 1961, the U.S. Air Force mobilized several F-104A units to Europe. The Starfighters flew air defense and escort missions over West Germany, demonstrating their quick reaction capabilities. Their presence helped deter potential aggression. The F-104's most extensive combat service was during the Vietnam War. It flew more than 5,000 sorties from 1965 to 1967. The F-104C, a multi-role fighter-bomber version, was used for air superiority and support roles. The F-104s escorted bombers on raids over North Vietnam and attacked enemy ground targets with bombs, rockets, and napalm. Although the F-104s scored no confirmed air-to-air kills, they were not shot down by enemy fighters. Most losses were due to anti-aircraft fire and surface-to-air missiles. Pilots praised the F-104's speed, climb, and firepower, but criticized its short range and high fuel consumption. In the Indo-Pakistani Wars of 1965 and 1971, the Pakistan Air Force used the F-104 against the Indian Air Force. The F-104s performed air defense, interception, and ground attack missions. They scored the first air-to-air kill by a Mach 2 aircraft when Flight Lieutenant Aftab Alam Khan shot down an Indian Dassault Mistral 4 with an AIM-9B Sidewinder missile. The F-104s also shot down other Indian aircraft, including a Canberra bomber and a NAT fighter. Indian pilots feared the F-104 and tried to avoid it. The F-104s suffered losses mostly to ground fire and missiles, and one to a MiG-21 in a rare supersonic duel. The F-104 was involved in several incidents that caused controversy and tragedy. One of the most famous was the mid-air collision between a NASA F-104N and an Air Force XB-70 Valkyrie bomber over California in 1966. The F-104N, piloted by NASA test pilot Joseph A. Walker, collided with the XB-70's vertical stabilizers, causing both aircraft to crash and killing Walker and the XB-70's co-pilot, Major Carl Cross. Another incident that tarnished the F-104's reputation was the bribery scandal in 1975. Lockheed had paid millions to foreign officials and politicians to secure contracts for the F-104 and other aircraft. The scandal involved several countries, including Germany, Japan, the Netherlands, and Italy. It also implicated figures like Prince Bernhard of the Netherlands and German Defense Minister Franz Josef Strauss. Pilots and crews had mixed opinions about the F-104. Some loved it, some hated it, and some respected it. It was praised for its speed, climb, and firepower, but criticized for its short range, high landing speed, and poor maneuverability. It was notorious for its high accident rate, especially in German service, where it earned the nickname Widowmaker. The F-104 required skill and discipline to fly, and any mistake could be fatal. Despite these challenges, the F-104 Starfighter was a record-breaking and award-winning aircraft. It set many world records and achievements. The first aircraft to fly at twice the speed of sound, reaching Mach 2.005 on May 16, 1958. The world speed record of 2,259.82 kilometers per hour on May 18, 1958. The world altitude record of 31,513 meters on December 14, 1959. The world climb rate record of 24,996 meters in 3 minutes 33 seconds on December 13, 1958. The first missile kill by a Mach 2 aircraft shooting down a Pakistani B-57 bomber with an AIM-9B Sidewinder on September 7, 1965. The first air transport delivery of a jet fighter using a C-124 Globemaster II to carry a disassembled F-104A to Taiwan on April 10, 1958. The F-104 also received many awards and honors, the Collier Trophy for the F-104A in 1958. The Harmon Trophy for Major Howard C. Johnson in 1958 and Captain Joe B. Jordan in 1959. The Thompson Trophy for Major Walter W. Irwin in 1958. The NASA Distinguished Service Medal for several F-104 pilots and engineers who contributed to the space program. The F-104 made many contributions and innovations. The boundary layer control system, which used engine bleed air to increase lift and reduce landing speed. The inertial navigation system, providing accurate position and velocity information without external references. The M61 Vulcan cannon, a 6-barrel rotary cannon that could fire up to 6,000 rounds per minute. The F-104 had a lasting impact on the history and culture of many countries and regions. NASA used it for research and training. It appeared in movies and books such as The Right Stuff and The Starfighters. It also became a collector's item for museums and private owners. In summary, the F-104 Starfighter was a remarkable aircraft that deserves our admiration and respect. It pushed the boundaries of aviation technology and performance despite its challenges and controversies. From setting world records to serving in various combat roles, the F-104 left an indelible mark on aviation history. That's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, remember to like, share, and subscribe. The sky is not the limit, it's just the beginning. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.